I have absolutely no idea what just happened. Is there a live feed going? Is that other live feed still going? I don't know. I'm just going to carry on with life. I honestly am not the techiest guy in town. We all know that. I'm just going to carry on with my life. I have no idea what just happened there. I said a live, and it said we were live, but we weren't live. I'll stick to the power sauce. And my mission at hand today. Joe Reynolds, how you doing, bud? I have no idea what just happened. None. Zero. I don't even know if that other live feed's still going. No idea. Let's have a look. YouTube. How's everybody? I know. That's funny. It's not even coming up. Too much power, I guess. I'll just finish my task at hand here and move on to the next thing. Double banger. Double banger. Woo. Okay, let's get on to the techie stuff, the not so important stuff. Let's be honest, it's not that important. Let's have a look. Let's see what they're telling me now. Is that other live feed still going? Let's see. Wi-Fi. Okay, well, I can tell why that's not working. There we go. Now that should work. That could be why that wasn't working too. That very well could be. Just like Tin Man, we don't know what we're doing. What do we got here? There's a live feed right there. Look at that. Live feed. Is that other chat still going, friends? It's already giving me ads. That's funny. Is that other chat still going, friends, on that other live feed? Please tell me it's gone. I have no idea about YouTube. Dude. Belgium. Bjorn. It's still going. Hilarious. I don't even know how they do that. How could they? Crazy. Hello, Buckin. Hello, Terry. Hello. Hi, everybody. Good to see us all. We got it on horizontal mode. You got to be happy about that. This looks good. It looks real good. Yes, the other feed is still... or was still going. Hello, Buckin. How are you? Hi there from Portugal, Virginia. 191 viewing. Is that on the other feed, Snowman? Or what's happening? Is that thing still clicking along? Because I don't see it. I don't even know how to find it. But I'm not going to spend too much freaking energy on that. I'll tell you that right now. I don't know what happened. I set up a scheduled, but that doesn't surprise me because I don't know what I'm doing. Let's turn the volume down. This was an axe. I think the other one has stopped now. Oh, Paige. Paige, good to see you, darling. Your old man's looking great. It's good to see you guys at Bunyan. Let's turn this down. Oh my goodness. Hello from Michigan. Wesley, good to see you, Wesley. Woo! Oh, that was crazy. Oh my goodness. I gotta loosen up. Ah. Yeah. I gotta play the blues. I got a little bit of blues out of me. I gotta let it go. I had some angst and some frustration when I was trying to get the live feed going, and it gave me some kind of angst a bit, you know? Coming. I feel it. It's coming. Starting to feel better now. Okay. I like that. We all have certain things we need to do to get back down to the love. I feel better. Now, back on track. Sorry for the kerfuffle this morning. Before we left for Paul Bunyan, friends, welcome to you if you're new here. We got the snowman here. We got John McCormick with the super chat. Good old Johnny throws a $20 super chat. Johnny, we love yous. Johnny super chat says, "Hi, Christine. Didn't mean to be pushy. I was running on about 3 hours of sleep and Thursday's adrenaline." Well, I don't think you could be pushy if you tried, Johnny McCormick. I still can't believe I got to see the famous Tin Man, Marty and Joe. Marty and Joe Reynes. And Brian, it was totally different this year from last year. You got to remember, friends. You got to remember. Well, you don't have to remember nothing. Buck and Billy Ray, I guess I'm growing. I'm growing. And with the infiltration now of a bigger audience, more people, more subscribers, Ripsaw set up this event that was beyond anything I expected. They were telling me things on the text, you know, "Hey, Buckin, we got this little tent. We're going to be all set up. We got a little whiteboard for you and this and that." And I was like, "Guys, just have a power saw for me there and a couple saws I can ramble on and talk about and cut in the pit. In the sawdust pit." So I get there and they got this tent set up, this freaking fence. They got all this stuff and they put on a freaking show. So if there was any crossed wires of anywhere, of anybody that was there, you do not say anything towards Ripsaw. It was on me. I own everything. Me, Buckin Billy Ray, not freaking Ripsaw, me. You hear what I'm saying? So if anything wasn't, you know, something happened that you were kind of thrown off, I'm talking to anybody. You talk to me. Me. Not Ripsaw. Those boys did an amazing job of setting up that big screen. And that was nuts. I felt honored. Let's put it to you straight. I felt honored that they would have enough trust in me to run their power saws wide open in 4-foot wood in front of a crowd. Think about that for a minute. So if there was any cross wires or if anybody, you know, please come to me. Come to me. Thank you. We're learning. We're growing. I want to put on more events. I want to do more of this stuff. So I hope that makes sense. But before we went there, I sold a few axes to get some loot going for the crew cab, and we got those. Those are all sold. I think we sold 12 axes. But there was a man named Tom Carlson. We auctioned off a wood bullet, and Tom Carlson on the last live feed said, "Hey, Buckin, I want to buy one more axe for you to give away at Bunyan." Tom Carlson, friends. We all know who Tom Carlson is. The last live feed, he showed who he was. He's a wild man. Anyways, please come and see me if you've got any questions about Bunyan. I'll be able to answer them for you. It was wild and crazy, and I loved every minute of it. I had these. It was crazy. Somebody said they saw me walking through the crowd with a freaking entourage of black shirts, and it was like this. Oh, it was crazy. It felt so good to be supported. A little small town freaking firewood faller woodman. This is crazy to me, friends. I love it. But I am learning to be, I guess I'm learning more in that stage, if that makes sense. So have patience with me, please. Anyway, enough ramble. Johnny McCormick, Christine, okay, we got that. Marty Rutter. Wish I could have been there, he says. Mark Gaines. Gainesies. Oh my gosh. Who's that? It's Captain. Oh my goodness, I missed freaking Super Chats. I was rambling. I get going. Don't. I'm just getting started, friends. You know that. Catbird. The Bradleys at Catbird Hill. Dr. Bradley. That's a big chunk, dough. That's a big chunk of dough, Johnny. Thank you. Joe Reynes with a Super Chat. Let's read this. Let's go through this. Great meeting the Buckin Army community at Bunyan. And so menu YouTubers. Joe Reynes, we love you, brother. Thank you. Joe's a stallion. We know this already about him. And we got Johnny McCormick. Thank you for the Super Chats, friends. Come to Montana and help Buckwood. Brandon, I'm going to be all over the place. My plan... If you've been here for long enough, you've heard me talk about traveling around and cutting trees with people. You've heard me say it, and it's going to happen. It already is happening. My plan is to cut. Mr. Ketchum, Donald Bailey. Donald had an accident, friends. Donald Bailey, he's in the chat right here right now, friends. Let's give some love to Donald Bailey. Donald's in the chat right now. I think I was in the process of talking about a kickback on Saturday. Was it Saturday you got hurt, Donald? Talk to us. Let's talk about it for a second. Donald Bailey, right here. Friends, turn your attention to Donald Bailey in the comment section, please. It was Thursday, he said. It was Thursday he got hurt. Buckin from Texas, was great to meet you at Bunyan. Donald Bailey got hurt on Thursday. He tripped and fell on his 500 eye, friends. It cut his neck up. It opened up his chest. It actually cut him up bad. And Donald will tell you right now, he'll tell you right now in the comment section, what could have saved this happening. Donald, the floor is yours. Lyle Davis, good to see you. Yeah, Yeah, he got it bad, friends. He got it real bad. I can show you pictures, but I'm not allowed to do that. They won't like this here. Old timer, good to see you. Prayers to you, Donald. Thank you, Larry Grimm. Larry, it was nice meeting you. The bellhopper. Danny Barth. Marty Rudder. Buckin, my friend. Tiven NC. Scott Price. Hey, is Daryl Smith around? Where's Daryl Smith? Daryl, are you here today, brother? Daryl Smith, are you here? It's so good to be home with my Huskies, friends. Mr. Ketchum. Come to Missouri, Walnut Capital. Oh, friends, that freaking... I'm just reading comments. Home is where the Huskies are. Yeah, I got one on my tailgate right now. We're going to go out there and have a look at it. Hello from South Dakota. Love your videos. Thank you, Mark. Appreciate you. Prayers to Donald Bailey. Donald Bailey Tree Service took two steps. It would not have happened. Okay, so here it is. Here it is. Donald, he's a goer. He's, when you run a tree service and you got guys working with you and you're on site, you're going because you're trying to make money. You're trying to get the job finished, collect the money, move on, pay your guys, get home. Okay, love you, babe. My wife's going down to the farm market. It's so nice to be home. Friends, we've put in so much effort into that 500i over the last couple of years. It's so nice to be back to my Huskies. These Ripsaw boys, man, I'm telling you, I've been going off about them enough, but I'm going to tell you this right now. You're going to see very big things from those boys. And they've helped me, and I've helped them, and I could not see a better, like, partnership to relate to this channel. Power saws, climbing gear, everything that I speak about, they're able to bring. So this has been a very neat little partnership that we're working on, a collaboration, if you will. Their lead times are going to go, they're going to shrink down to nothing from what they're doing. So I'm excited about this. I'll probably head back out. So friends, Donald tripped and he didn't have his handbrake on his power saw. He didn't have it on. I'll be honest, not a lot of guys do. I've had my power saw. I've been up on a side hill and I've gone head, you know, ASS over tea kettle. And the first thing I do is I whip the saw. I've thrown my saw over my shoulder. I've thrown it to the side, both sides. If you'd seen Donald's wounds, you would be putting your handbrake on walking around the job site. You would be. This was a complete freak accident for Donald. It's the evolution of a saw guy that gets lucky. You got lucky by the look of your neck, brother. You got real lucky. I was demonstrating kickback at Paul Bunyan. And I got your text. It was crazy. Crazy. Anyway, thanks to our super chatters again. Lieutenant Bradley, it's so good to see you. Please say hi to your wife. It was too fast to throw, just a freak accident. Absolutely. It was bad, those pictures. Yeah, I showed Christine the pictures, Donald. It was ugly. Friends, listen, I'm gonna say this right now. 245 people here. Listen. I just lost a buddy, and they found him dead in his car there about a month ago. And he's a very close friend of mine who's been on, he's been on a bad road for many years. And I'm going to his his funeral, his celebration of life next Saturday. Well, my mom called me up and she said, Buckin, let's do a song. Let's play a song for Trevor because he was a musician. I've been in bands with Trevor and played sports with Trevor. And he was just a good friend. Probably my best friend a few years back in school. We hung out daily. I was friends with his family. Anyways, he's gone. My mom called me up and said, let's get together and do a practice on a couple of songs and play music at his deal coming up this weekend. So if you don't follow my Instagram, I urge you to go over my Instagram and check out my last post or two. Follow me on Instagram is what I'm telling you. Music is a big part of my life. And I spent the last 30 years feeding a family, running a business and feeding a family. And you guys know the story. I get a little bit kind of watery when I start thinking about the journey and thinking about my buddy Trevor now. He's just gone. He chose to just not live. That's a personal choice. Addiction is everywhere, and it's not pretty. And I tread lightly there on my channel. The only reason I'm here is because I quit drinking and drugging. Most of yous who have been here know that. You all know that, most of yous. But when I get a call from a dear friend bawling her eyes out, who I was the best man at his wedding, and they found him in a car overdosed on fentanyl in Vancouver. I look up, and whatever that moment was for me 27 years ago, to shake my head and say, I'm going to die. I'm going to die. And I'm okay with it. I'm going to die. And a knock come on the door of my house. Stephanie, she knocked on my door looking for me. Where are you, Buckin? Where are you? Look at you. So if some of you are new and you wonder where I'm coming from sometimes, addiction is a bad ordeal. And if you're struggling with alcohol and drugs, and I don't use my recovery and that part of my life as a platform or a vehicle to get views or to build a channel or build a community. I've never used it. It's part of my story. Some people like to use that as their thing. I would rather use working hard, being honest, and being kind. Those are the three things that put me in the position I'm in right now in my life. And I got a lot of young men looking at me and reaching out to me. I can only go by example. That's all I can do is go by example. I'm 54. I'm smashed to rat. You know what? But I'm just moseying along. I'm just moseying along in love and gratitude. I honestly feel like, and I'm not going to get goofy on you, but I honestly feel like the big fella had a hand in it somehow. Do you know what I mean? When that snag was coming down to just... Why do I get to tell the story? Do you know how common the story is? Faller dies, leaves wife and three kids. Faller dies, leaves wife and two kids. That story's common here. It's a statistic. Power saws ain't everything to me. Sage Breast Hillbilly, thank you for being here. It's absolutely free to be kind and cost the universe not to. Sage, thank you, buddy. I want to publicly thank Tin Man for packing up his knapsack and coming and helping me at the Paul Bunyan Show. Tin Man, I'll never be able to thank you. Your support in being there with me. I asked you to come. And you came. You said to your wife and child, who's like one year old or whatever, and you said, I'm going to support Buckin and Ripsaw at the Paul Bunyan Show. And you came. I also want to thank... Actually, I want to thank Marty Rutter. And and Joe Reynas, which we talked about earliest, and Brian, who showed up last year first on the scene. First on the scene with me and Nick Pixel with a freaking trailer and a literal knapsack over my back. We asked Bunyan for a table. Christine sent a box of freaking shirts, and we had a box of axe handles. That was our first Paul Bunyan. Nick Pixel picked me up at the freaking airport. I lived with him and his family in a trailer on the side of his house for a few days, and he got me to Bunyan. And you people helped and were part of that. This year was much different. It was much different. I know that. And it was a change. And next year will be much different. But after this event, I'm thinking we need two events every year. A Buckin Stock, where it's just Buckin Stock, peace, love, and power saws. And then another like a Bunyan, where you can reach out, grow connections, grow your business, that type of thing. I'm hoping to have two next year because I go to those things for one reason and one reason only. Friends, do you know how hard it is for me to stand in one place like this? To stand like this? Look at me right now. Look at me. I'm always doing stuff and weird things. My body doesn't do good standing there. We did two meet and greets for 2 hours. 2 hours! That's why I go. That's why I go. Friends, I'm telling you. It's you. It's not me. It's you people. That's why I come. I don't need to travel across the countryside. I want to travel across the countryside. I want to come and see you. I want to grow. I want to reach more people. I actually want to do a lot more, to be honest with you, in a few genres in our world. And my voice is getting a little loud right now because I'm getting a little serious about it. And I might swear. That's how passionate I get about certain things. But I don't swear because I know there's young kids watching right now. And I don't need to swear to get my point across. Now, I don't need to yard on my suspenders. I need to show and be action. I need to be action. Not for one day, not for 2 days. For years and years and years. Action. Love. I don't need to justify my existence to you or tell you anything about what I do. I choose to show you what I want to show you and share with you what I want to share with you. I think you folks have been here long enough. You understand where I'm coming from. Catch me in some drama. Tell me right now. Give it to me right now. Here, I'm looking. I'm waiting. Catch me in some drama. Where did you catch me in some drama? I'm waiting. Catch me beating somebody up. Catch me raising stink on YouTube. Show me. Show me. I'm waiting. Doesn't happen. Marty Rutter, guess what? This is yours. This is from a wonderful supporter from our channel and a man who knows my heart, like Laura Rose, Marty, Joe Reynas, Brian, the people that I connect and talk to after these events, to reach out to them, to ask them, what did you think? What can we do better? Know what I mean? I give a hoot. I give a care. So Marty Rutter, you were there to the very end, helping Scott, the organic oil fella that I raised up at that show. There was two people I was raising up. There was Ripsaw and this organic oil that I've been got behind because I freaking love it. And Marty, you were there packing that guy's bags with him, helping him. To the very end. For that reason, Marty Rutter, Tom Carlson purchased an axe for me to give away at Bunyan. And it was to be you. And I got so wrapped up in the craziness that I didn't do it. But I'm doing it today, Marty Rutter. I built this before I left. It is a Buckin special, thinned out Buckin handle, high test Tasmanian pattern, freaking Buckin special. Okay, Marty Rudder? This axe is for you. Today, we're giving it to you. This community's giving it to you. Via Tom Carlson, who is one of the channel's biggest, humblest, quietest supporters. Almost gets me choked up. He knows what's in here. He knows what's in here. So that's enough. That's enough of me going off. I hope you get where I'm coming from. These power saws and the rest of this stuff, that's a bonus. I've been saying it for a year. Since February? You know what I've been? I feel like a deer that got hit by a car. Actually, if you want to know the honest truth, physically, I have felt like a deer that got hit by a car and's been limping along physically. I was praying and hoping that when I got to Bunyan that I could jump inside that sawdust pit and be the man that I wanted to be. I was hoping and praying. You saw about 75-80% of what I would have liked to have been, to be quite honest. But I'm coming. I'm getting there. And I just wake up in the morning and I assess the damages. And I find out what can I do for my surroundings today. Not what can I get. What can I get today? It's what can I do today. The old saying, I don't know who said it. It's not what my country can do for me. It's what can I do for my country. It's the same stuff. So stop talking about it and freaking start doing it. Don't be afraid to love. Don't be afraid to love. Don't be afraid to help someone. Don't think about it. Because if you think about it, you'll screw it all up and you'll find reasons and fearful reasons to not do it. Just go with your gut. Feel. You guys know my message. Marty Rudder, this is a dandy. I'm hot today, friends. I'm hot. I'm real hot. This, I'm telling you, you people, I love you all so much for coming here. I love this community. It's crazy, but we are getting bigger. We're growing. We're growing. So I'm adapting. I can take this wherever I want to take it, friends. We can take it wherever we want to take it. We can. So where do I want to put my energy? Well, young men is definitely one place I would like to address. Families. Not everybody wants to learn to file a power saw, friends. That's an osmosis win here, in my mind. So, you're going to see some interesting things over the next while here. And I don't have anything specifically planned, except living with this thing going forward. Taking care of me. Because without me, I got nothing for you. The deer that got hit by the car, right? Remember? So, just know that this 54-year-old man, I've got this freaking burning fire in my guts. You know what I mean? And I'm competitive. Oh, I'm competitive. But I'm also smart. Very smart. In a sense that it's like the cat. My cat, when I came home from, remember my cat was dying? And that squirrel ran across its nose? You guys have heard me say this before. Give me the heck yes. You've heard me talk about this. If I ain't strong, then I will hold back. I will lay back. I will get strong. I seriously wake up every morning and I assess the damages, friends. This isn't a joke. It's what it's like for me. I'm going to try and get my x-rays. Not that I have to, but my x-rays are a laugh when I got smashed by that tree. They're an absolute laugh. I was laying there flat, and I heard the four or five of the doctors, you know, they were in there, and this is what I heard. I'm serious. I was behind the curtain. My wife was with me, and I heard, oh, ooh, ouch, ooh. This was the four doctors. This is what they were saying to themselves. I could hear them. And I said, I could hear them. So I said, not too good or what? What's going on in there? And this is what one of them said to me. It was May. It was May 25th. And they said to me, one of them said, well, William, I don't think you're going to be running through November. Let's just say that. You're not going to be running through November. May, June, July, August, September, October, November. Oh my goodness. I played music with my mom last night. Oh, it was so fun. It was so fun. Let's go outside for a minute. Did that other live feed go away, friends? Christine, is it gone now? That was weird. I don't even know what happened there. Is it gone now? How many of you peoples, think that this world is a little bit saturated with people yelling in your face to tell you what to do? Who, and all the, I can't even talk about it. I can't do it. I can't even talk about it. Why can't I talk about it? Because it gives it energy. Do you want to know how serious I am about energy? Do you want me to give you a little insight of how serious I am about giving something attention? Like when somebody comes at me in my comment section about something or other. This is how serious I am about it. I hear you, brother. Come here. I love you, buddy. I love you. Right on. Hey! I'm gonna talk to the young men right now. I'm gonna talk to the men right now, right here, right now. I'm gonna start it right now. Do you think that people will think you are weak? Is that why you engage in silliness? And this? Oh, well, that's what I'm blah, 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 blah. Tell me. Oh, I want to know honestly. You know the best thing to do is ignore it. Come on, you do. You know this. We've been taught this as children. Are you afraid someone will think you're weak because you don't reply or don't justify your existence to someone? Is that what you think? Well, it's the exact opposite. You've just bit the hook and you validated this, the other side for you. You've now validated. You've given him his shot of dopamine. He called you out. He threw the hook and you bit it. You bit it. I hope you understand where I'm coming from. This is one small aspect of my thought process. So anyways, back to the how serious I am about energy and giving energy to something. Give energy to love. Give energy to something else. Here it is in a nutshell. Check out this one. Whatever your connection is, Buddha, Jesus, God, Allah, whatever. Whatever your religion or belief is, it don't matter to me, but whatever that is, and whoever you talk to and reach out to for power and faith and all knowing, whoever that is for you, when I'm praying on my knees in the morning to my understanding of the all knowing, if I need more patience, I don't say to him, let's just use the word God, I don't say, please remove the intolerance from me. Please remove this intolerance and this impatience. I don't say that. if I want something to go away. Because I've just gave the intolerance and the impatience more energy by talking about it. I say, thank you for the patience and the tolerance. Thank you. Because you've already effing given it to me. So I already have it. Instead of giving energy to the other. Which all comes from fear. That's all I'm going to say because I'm getting rip, snorting, roaring right now. Take it for what you want. Just so you understand me a little more. Now. Portland. Welcome, Portland. Good to see you. Love you, Buckin. Robbie Egan, good to see you. Robbie Egan. Hey, friends, do you remember Rob from the graveyard? The freaking dude showed up at Bunyan. He showed up at Bunyan. That's like me going to Bunyan. Rob, Graveyard Rob, was at Bunyan. Nuts. Nuts. This is the icing on the cake. I know Buckin's heart's in the right place. Be kind. Christ is the answer. For you, that's good, George. Good man. Stay convicted, brother. Don't squander. Just stay convicted to whatever you got, brother. Just remember, George, other people's may not be the same as yours. Just understand that. That's where the breakdown is. You see what I'm saying, bro? Good for you, George. Glad you got something. My buddy came running back up in the camper at Bunyan, says, you wouldn't believe it. Buckin got bodyguards. He's got these two men. Dude, that was so fun. Ripsaw boys all dressed in black. Wasn't that hilarious? I loved it. That was funny. There's a backstory to that. You'll probably never know it, but there is. That was beautiful. Paris. Wow. Marty Rutter. My favorite video of you dealing with negativity is when you bent over laughing through your butt when that lady threatened you. Oh my gosh, do you remember that? Listen, I'm not kidding you. Listen, you got me going. Friends, you got me going. You don't have to be here. I'm not trying to sell you nothing. If you like it here, that's great. If you don't, that's great too. But I will tell you something. You have to honor yourself. Honor thy own self. Here's a little example. If I love everybody. I love human beings. I do. If you dislike me and have ill will to me, I actually love you. I do. That took a long time for me to learn that. I may not like you. I may not like you. And I won't shake your hand. Because if I reach out and shake someone's hand that I don't like, I have just dishonored myself. And I will go lie down and go, why did I do that? Why did I do that? You understand? So you will know if I like you or not. But just remember this. I do love you. I do love you. And I want nothing but for you to win. In every aspect of your life. But beating upon other people and fearing that you're not going to have, then you're not going to have. If you fear that you're not going to have, then you are not going to have. Because what you fear, you attract. It's happened to me. I've lived it. So I forget it all now and just love and just be nice. I don't care. I've got the other side. We've all got it. We've all got it. We were born with it. It's there. Trust me. It's there if I need it. Storing energy. Tough guy stories make me boring. Tough guy stories make me yawn. But I remember the exact video you're talking about where that lady... Yeah, that was hilarious. Don't give your power away, friends. Young men, listen. I don't know what you do, where you spend your time on the internet, but this kibbling that goes on and this fighting that goes on on these internet channels, and all these, what are you doing? What are you doing? Have you not got enough going on in your own life to lift people up? That part, man, I honestly don't understand it. I don't understand it. I know it's society. I know. But I ain't having no part of it. Zero. Good afternoon, Alan. Hello, Mark. Joe Reynas. Marty Rudder. Mark and Spider. Brian Johnson. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know, but that's... I can love people and not like them. You know when I learned to do that? I'll tell you this quite honestly. When I learned to do that, I was 27, actually. 27 or 28 years old. Right when I sobered up. And I did a lot of work on myself back in them days. And I'm still working on myself and still learning about myself. But the last thing you will catch me doing is taking my life out on anybody. I won't take my life out on you. If I'm not feeling good, I just go lie down like a dog or a deer that gets hit by a car and lick my wounds. You won't catch me being rude to you because I'm not in a good mood. That just won't happen. I will look you right in the face and say, you know what, brother? I love you. I don't have it right now for you. I don't have the energy for you, and I can't carry on this conversation. I'll just be very honest. What you do with that is up to you. So I learned how to communicate with people and how to look after myself without throwing fisticuffs, if that makes sense. Anyway, we got another super chatter in here. $50 super chatter. Somebody threw it in there. I'm going after him right now. Who did this? Or is this an old one? It's Daryl freaking Smith. Daryl, I was looking for you. Where did you go, dude? See, this is what I'm talking about right here. Daryl comes up to me. The freaking guy's been super chatting like a wild man for the last few months. Like big time. Daryl Smith, right there. I saw him. I hugged him. I thanked him. And then as soon as I turned my head, boom, you're gone. It's Daryl, brother. Thank you, buddy. You're such a good dude. This is... Friends, please thank Daryl. Daryl freaking Smith. Nice meeting you and Wendy, Christine, Tin Man, and you, Buckin. Daryl, oh, dude. This is nuts. We got to have a Buckin stock. It's just that simple. We got to have a Buckin stock. Daryl, thank you. Thank you, brother. Wow. From Romania. With power, you are the best. UAE. UAE. Yes, brother. Romania. I love it. Let's make peace, brother. Let's make peace. Let's do it. I love this. Chris Nash. Super chat. Chris, we love you. Thanks, Daryl. Bjorn. Tin Man. Thank you to everyone who signed my helmet. Ha, Michael. folks here. Pretty cool. Friends, you've got, please go to my freaking Instagram. Follow me on Instagram and check out my second to last post. My mom's singing at 78 years old. She's belting out a tune called Stray Dog. She's a stray dog. And we're going to record that song. I'm doing the drums, she's singing, Wayne's on the bass. Go check out my freaking Instagram. Let's rock. Let's do it. Positivity begets positivity. Just freaking be nice to people. Treat people how to treat you. Treat people how you want to be treated. We know all these things, friends. We all know them. What stops us from doing it? What people will think if they see someone coming at you, but you go, do you think they're going to think you're weak? No, you're going to think you're weak. They're going to think, that guy just put a damper on that fella's sauce, didn't he? I'm just using this as an analogy, friends. I think you, and I hope you understand where I'm coming from. I just want love. I said this a while back in my videos. You don't like me? Stop persecuting yourself. Just hit the road. Leave a chair for someone who actually likes me or loves me. It's that simple. You're not chained here. We're not chaining you down. We're just trying to grab some folks that want to let the car go in front of them. You know, somebody's trying to merge in or you're, you know, let me get that for you. Open the binders up a little bit. Lose this. Lose this. Open them up. Hey, you need a hand, bud? You doing okay? Right on. Let's go. Let's do this. Come in the sandbox. Just clicking in. Action. Knowing is one thing. Knowing how to be nice and knowing what I should do is great. And understanding it. But doing it, that's where the change comes. That's where the change comes. Friends, if you hadn't known me back in the day, I'm I love life so much. I love human beings. I actually love men. I love human beings, but men were so... That tin man. Oh. Daryl Smith, thank you. Thank you. I had 70-year-old men come up to me. Clow, are you in there? Clow, speak up if you're in there, brother. Come up to me and just look me in the face and go, you know, what? And they just go like this. They didn't know what to say, but they waited in line, 200 people, whatever it was, I don't know. They waited in line. I'm talking older men, older than me, to come and shake my hand and say, I watch your stuff and I like your stuff. Thank you. Not that younger men's opinions of me, everyone's opinions are great, but when an older man comes up to you, someone in their 70s and says, you're real and I like what you're doing, I like your message, my boots settle into the sand a little more, they settle in a little bit and I go, okay, this is helping. Your input is helping. Clell, are you still here? You're probably not. I've been yelling today. You got a mellow soul. Holga, Marty Rudder. Gwen, that's saying something, Buckin. Well, I believe it is because I respect my elders. I'm not looking for pats on the back right now. I'm just speaking truth. My truth. So, Todd, getting some clogger defender pro pants. Good. You got to have your safety pants on for sure. Good man. Buckin, your message is contagious. Love it, brother. Robert Jones, I love you. Lyle Davis, respect is well earned, Buckin. Lyle Davis, you got a few years on me, brother. I love you, Lyle. Hey, Buckin, did you have a chance to see my message? Which one's that, Pim? I just saw this one. Kindness doesn't cost a thing. No, it does not. My brother, Andrew Ketchum. Andrew, you're looking well, brother. Marty Rudder, you're in for a bit of a surprise, brother. You are. That's got Marty Rudder written all over it right there. Done deal. Tom Carlson, Marty Rudder, and the messengers of kindness who support this channel in super chats or monthly. These boys, this is how this happens. You people. So don't forget it. We love you all. Thank you for clicking on the videos. Okay, what just happened here? Mark Gaines, a little extra for the crew cab. Oh, Gainesies. Here's another fella. Mark Gaines has been here for freaking years. Gainesies. Mark, thank you so much. Do you know what? There's a crew cab right across the street. They moved in. It's kind of like a monster truck. You may have seen it in some of the videos when I leave the house. It's a 73. I'm looking for a full-on cab for that truck. That is the missing link. So those axes I sold, they're going to help get that. It's tucked away in a little account. Crew cab. Crewkey. It's called Crewkey. And you're going to watch it happen. It's going down. Uh-oh, who's that? Tom Carlson did a super chat. Tom Carlson's here. Christine, did you hear that beep? Tom Carlson, where are you? Where's Tom? Right there, Tom Carlson. Buckin' stock would be great. There's Tom Carlson right there. I didn't even see it. Tom Carlson. Tom, Marty Rutter got the axe, Tom. I don't know if you saw that. Yeah, Marty Rutter. Tom, we love you. Thank you, brother. We're doing a Buckin' stock. It's settled. It's settled. We have to spread these out and pick the proper times to do this. We're doing a peace, love, and power saws is what we're doing. We'll light the camp. We'll light the campfires. We'll sit around, throw some axes around, right? Yeah, maybe we'll get a couple sponsors or something to help out with travel. Maybe this oil company, maybe he'll help us. Maybe he'll come. Ripsaw, who knows? We'll set it up. We'll set it up. Tom Carlson, thank you, brother. We'll make it happen. BuckinBillyRay.com helps. That all helps when you guys go in there and buy t-shirts. Get the gullet. That always helps. And I don't pitch myself that much. I'm not good at it. I don't do short videos telling you to run over to my website and buy stuff. I don't utilize the tools that are given to me to create revenue. I just don't. I'm known for it. I get trouble actually for it. So when we put on an event, all this stuff helps immensely. So thank you. Tom Carlson, we love you. Thanks to all our super chatters today thus far. Helga, Buckin, Pim needs some advice. He's not doing well. Okay, Pim, I'm here. Helga, thank you for that, letting me know. Pim, I'm right here, brother. Pim, I'm waiting for your comment now. They fly by pretty quick, brother. I hope so, Laura. Pim. If people is doing something very wrong, they will be, okay? John Clark, George Kelly, Christine, new stuff coming to the store at the end of the month. We got new designs coming. Pim, I'm waiting to talk to you, brother. Jamie Bark and Spider, the axe is something else. I've been swinging her. You got her, James. You got your axe. You! So, hey, Pim, where'd you go? Tomorrow is another day, and every day will get better. I know this. Donald, get well. Hope the crew helps get better. He's got a good crew. Mark had a super chat. Mark Gaines. Yes, we thank Mark Gaines. Is that who you're talking about? Marky Gaines? Pim, I lost my job. Company went bankrupt. My wife cheated on me, and I lost my best friend. He died. All within 2 weeks. I'm so lost, man. Pim. So, how does that make you feel, Pim? Feel. Not think. How does it make you feel, Pim? Lost? I'm so lost. Well, you know, Pim, I'm not going to compare some of my down times to what you're going through right now. That's not what this is about. But if you only knew, Pim, listen to me. You've asked. You've asked me, brother. I don't have any magical words. But I want you to know something, Pim, as I look into your face. Whatever's happening right now is the right plan. Whether you're able to accept that right now, that's not for me to worry about. That's on you. You're going through it. Does it suck right now? It probably does. It probably does because it's new and it's change. But if you could transjector a year down the road or 6 months down the road, maybe even sooner, Pim, you're going to be surprised what's going to happen to your life. You're going to be very surprised. So these things are supposed to happen or they wouldn't have happened, brother. That's all I know. I don't have any magical words. All I know is we love you, brother. And everybody goes through these things. And I never could have known getting hit by a tree and almost dying was going to turn my life into what it is now. I didn't know that was going to be part of my journey. I didn't know that I was... I never knew that I would thought that I would never walk again or if this... You know what I mean? This is what went through my mind. I thought it was over. But it had only just begun. So, Pim... We're here, brother. We're here in this community for you. That's all I can say. But know this, brother. Know this. You have a choice how you want to experience this. You can go into a deep dive if you like, or you can look up and you can go, thank you. Thank you to whatever you're connected to. And you can thank them. Because trust me, brother, it's the right plan. You may not know it right now and you may not feel it, but I'm telling you right now, and I believe it in my heart, it is the right thing. So I would actually turn this around and say thank you. Thank you for this. You asked me, Pim, and that's what I think. I'm not going to sugarcoat it, brother. Everybody in this community says they're here for you, and I don't believe they're lying to you, Pim. You want to stay connected? Stay somewhere where there's no fighting going on? No tough guy stories? No competition? Competition's old to me. I used to compete in a lot of different things. Competition is boring. I make my stand when it's time. It's there. If I need to show my hackles, they're there. Trust me, brother, they're there. But I don't use them. I prefer not to. Leon Shuffalovsky, Buckin, love you, brother. Wish I could have made Bunyan. Thanks for all that you do for coming into my life. Much love to you and the army. Leon Shuffalovsky, what a man. This is, friends, this is huge. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Brian Hebert, hey, Buckin was serious about helping with Buckin stock. Have a trailer full of tools. We'll travel. Brian, I'm going to call on you. I'll call on you. Thank you. We need a place to do it. We need friends, believe it or not, putting on a Buckin stock. It's not just, hey, let's get together. We have to get lawyers. We have to sign waivers. It's not hilly willy nilly, friends. That's why Ripsaw was careful. Friends, I'm just telling you, it wasn't like last year. We somebody cuts themselves or gets hurt. Ay, 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 ay. It's a big ordeal. I've learned this going forward. We have to do this right. Pam, we love you. Meeting and sharpening, sharing my personal stories and how you helped me through it is one of the best things for me in the past few years. You and this community. Shane Reynolds, good to see you, brother. Thank you for your support, brother. Thank you for the super chat. We appreciate it. Mr. Shuffalovsky. Brian Hebert. Mark Gaines. Thomas Carlson. Daryl Smith. Cat Bird Hill, Lieutenant Bradley, all the super chatters, thank you again. It's crazy. It's actually crazy. I hope I didn't miss anybody. Pim, just hang with us, brother. Just take our love, Pim. Will you please, Pim? Pim, I'm talking to you, Pim. Take our love, brother. Will you please accept it? Accept the love coming to you, brother. Trust me. Just accept it. This is supposed to happen, brother. And I think deep down in your heart, you know that. I believe you know it. I believe we all know it. We're just not ready to accept it yet. That's all, brother. It'll come. It'll come, buddy. That's a lot to happen to a fella, Pim. Talk about how strong you're going to be. I wouldn't want to play with you in about 6 months. You're going to be one strong Sangan, Pim. Huh? Come on. The Pimster. Pimolinskin. The Pimolamarama. Pimolanjunja Jalabi Bim Pim Pam Pom. Pimsky. Pim. Pimorosa. Pimolinskin Skanskin. Huh? Pim, if you're not smiling, we got problems. Pimsky! Turbo Tate! Pim, where'd you go? Oh, you got a smile. We got a smile out of Pim, friends. Piminski. Big Buck spreading the love and kindness. Keep fulfilling your dream, all Woods Miller. Big decision and much more give my brothers wow. Pim, you will come out stronger. Thanks to all those I met at Bunyan. You were all so nice. And many wonderful comments. The memories are with me forever. Love the axe behind the stove. Cheers, everybody. Thanks, Dale. Arbory Masteries. Please discuss boring to eliminate kickback. Pulling chain. Is that what you're talking about? Still here, brother. Pim. Good man, Pim. Sass says it's better than church. Brother, love is better than anything. It just is. Come on, you can't argue with that, brother. Love has a hand in everything. There's nothing you can say about love. It stands like the big oak in the windstorms. Love will always stand in the wind. Like a husky in the windstorms and the blizzards. It just stands there and squints its eyes like this. Love is real. Fear is fantasy. Love has a peace in everything. It's just a matter if you want to give it some energy or not. I sure do. That's why I can love the snot out of you, but not like you. Arbor Masteries. That would be a discussion on... the stump, brother. That's not something I can verbalize and mumble. That we don't do a lot of bore cutting here. There has to be a reason to bore cut. We don't, you understand? Like you must know it's different here than it is in the hardwoods. It just is. This is a conversation that's very common, but there's a way to do bore cuts and there's a way to fight bore cuts. Bore cuts don't have to be on you know what I'm saying, brother. We'll get into that. We'll get into it. Bore cuts are really hard on power saws. And raker height is very important. You know what I mean? if your chain's haywire, it's all the reason why to use a raker gauge. Your bore cuts, if your rakers aren't too hungry, your bore cuts should come out smooth. None of this. You know what that does to the crankcase and the saw? And they burn up quick. Dave Slinger, I love this. Listen to Dave. This is beautiful. I don't understand why a Canadian tree man has helped my mental health, but I don't care. It works. David, brother, I love you, man. Davey, that's some funny stuff. I haven't even started, brother. You've seen me go off a few times, Dave. I know you have. Christine, am I missing anything? I sure hope I'm not missing anything. Christine keeps me in gear. Christine and Laura Rose and you people help behind the scenes. I love you. Thank you. All right. Jimmy, the autism I have. Sean Capps, you've been here for a long, long time. Sean, you know, it's funny. I used to think way back. Sean, how long have you been here? Sean Capps, come on, give it to me straight. Do you like Star Trek? Sean? Sean Capps, I'm talking to you. And I want an answer, young man. Do you like Star Trek? And are you smiling right now and is your heart pumping? Huh? Come on. Give it to me. Friends, I've lost weight. I'm just about at the stage now, physically, where I can start. You know, like, not yet, not quite. That's only like 5 pounds. Like, I still, friends, I'm not kidding. I'm not joking around. That's why I keep my shoulders below my nipples. As soon as they go there, it's coming. Christine, you are doing well today. I am very pleased with you. That I am. Sean Capps, buddy, you are... Where are you from, Sean? Outer space? Sean Capps? I love you. You're the man, Buckin. Fence Post Joe says you're the man, Buckin. Raising my spirits and talking me back to my roots in the timber. Love you, brother. Love you too, Fence Post. Oh, my wife's going to cook me such a lovely... Oh, do you know what, friends? My wife and I are kind of empty nesters. Listen, friends, you're talking to a dude. That's why I say I'm evolving, because... My kids are grown freaking up. We're empty nesters pretty much almost now. It's just me and my darling. Get a good person to travel the world with. Find someone that you can, that doesn't want to fight. Find someone who doesn't want to be petty and head trip and head game and be right all the time. Find someone you can just go, let's just be happy. Can we just be happy? If you're not happy, the both of you are not going to be happy. If I don't have me, you know what I'm talking about? And having me is having something else. I don't care what it is. I honestly don't. I've said it before. It matters not to me what you put all your faith and belief in. I do not care. I have a sandbox that I play around in. I don't care if you're black, white, brown, red, polka dotted, it, big, small, get in here. Get into the sandbox and let's play together and build something together. None of that matters to me. None. People, this thing of, you don't have that. Well, this is the only way to do that. This is the only way. This is the only way for forgiveness and the only way for peace. No, unfortunately, it's not. I hate to break it to you. But if you believe in that, that's okay with me. And if that's all you believe in, I bless you on your way and I love you and I would like to give you a hug. But please don't force your opinions upon me. Because I'm happy. I'm connected. I'm good. I'm good. Believe it in your heart. I'm good. Like real good. All right. Good to see you today. Okami! Okami! Devin, did you know that Ripsaw didn't even know you were the guy that we gave the power saw to? Dev, did you know that? That's on me. That's not on Ripsaw. That's on me. I was freaking. Freaking! I will be better next time. I will be better. There's another thing. Listen, anybody, because I know people in their 70s who act like they're 13. I just do. If you're a young man and you've screwed up and you know you've screwed up, there's nothing wrong with saying, hey, bud, I'm getting this feeling that I might have hurt your feelings. And if I did, I'm sorry. Or just, I'm sorry. Hey, own your shite. Take responsibility. Don't blame. Oh, well, you did this. And I screwed up. I'm sorry. Do you know how freeing that is? Guess what happens after you do that? You go like this. I gotta go walking down the street again. Hey, bud. How's she go? What was that? You need to talk to me? Sure. What was that? Oh, sure. Absolutely. Yeah. No problem. But if you didn't do that, and if you're lying and cheating and stealing and being mean to people and not saying sorry and doing things, you're more like this. I ain't got nothing to hide. I got nothing to hide. I don't need to justify my existence to you. Do good things and justify to no one. I've been talking about this stuff for years on this channel. These little sayings I used to put up in the videos. Do good things and justify to no one. Hey, Buckin, why are you doing an undercut like that? Oh, that's just how I do it. Well, I do it this way and that's better because of this and that. Oh, all right on. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye-bye. I don't need it. All the information. We don't even need to go to school anymore with the internet. People complain about having their kids go into school, about the way things are going with all the craziness that's going on. Well, then take your kid out of school. Stop complaining about it. Take your kid out of school. Solution. I'm a solution man. I'm not a fighting man. I don't like arguing and bickering about the silliest little things. And another thing. You know, another thing that's really hard, and young men, if you're watching me going on your journey, or if anybody's moving along, they're traveling along, as soon as you can get rid of the word should out of your vocabulary, the better you're going to be. I should, oh, do you know what I should have is? This is what I should have is. This is what I should have. I should have done this, or you should have done that. So put it this way. I should have. Right? Or you should have. That's what that is. Should. I should have. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Not what I should have done. I know I should have done. Let's move on. That's done. I need to figure out and put my energy towards making it better. If I need to say sorry for something I've done, I got no problem doing that. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It's me. Are you listening? I said I'm sorry. People are so fixated on fighting and getting their point across, they don't even hear anything anymore. Wow. Buckin's hot today. Where did I put my glasses? Okay. I think I should go. I've rambled enough today. There's no cutting. There's no nothing going on today. What there is, though, Let's go out here. I don't even know what happened today on this freaking thing. You guys remember that oil I was talking about? It's mild out today. Oh, my dear goodness gracious me. What's that? What is that? Wow. Check this out. This has been sitting for a while. Look. Look at this. Look at this stuff. Look at this oil. Look at this stuff. It's a golden dust. I just got four more boxes of this stuff from Scotty. I'm rocking this stuff big time. Look at the bar. Dave Slinger, I try to keep a soft touch on what I'm doing today. I don't like to ramble and yell in people's faces, but I got a lot to say, as you know, Dave, and not everyone is here for the same reason. So I have kind of a big demographic that I speak to, and I want everyone to feel happy and be happy and spread love. I know you know this, David, and that's why I sometimes ramble about spiritual items. Do you understand me, David? I know you do. I know you do, Dave. I know you understand me. I have a lot to say, and I wanna be soft in that approach. I don't know. You know what I mean. I don't like telling anybody what to do. I just like to share what has and does bring me peace. That's it. That's all. Because life's got a lot more to do for me than just cutting and power saws and treeing and that. Let's be honest, Davey. I'm 54, dude. I mean, I could continue to just keep cutting. I could shut this channel down tomorrow and go make a great living cutting trees. Is that a smart decision? Not at all. Not at all. So, this little guy here is my husky. This is how I would go about. So, you guys saw the chain, right? Oh, my God. Okie. Hey, someone just super chatted. I saw in the background there just as I was walking away. What's going on here? Okie, I love you, Buckin, and everyone else here. Spread the message. Okie, thank you for the super chat, brother. Thank you, pal. We appreciate you. Go get yourself one of these. Go get yourself one of these. Go to Ripsaw and see if they've got these in stock. If they don't, tell them to get them. Just get one of these. Okay? Now. Just a second. Okay, so you guys saw the, I can bring you guys closer if you want to watch a close-up here. Give that oil a try. I want to hear what you guys think of that oil that got that oil at the bunion. I want to hear what you say. What's happening here? You guys, oh yeah, okay. So, friends, we're wiped, right? Like, we're wiped. There's nothing left on this chain. I'm right at the line. Did you see it? This will probably rattle around on here too. This might not be great here. I'm already moving. Look at that. Yeah, this might not be the greatest. This oil, I'm like right at the end of this. You guys are shaking, rattling, and rolling, aren't you? So there's nothing left on. I should almost show this to you. Do you guys want to do a quick setup on this? Do you want to see how this goes? Give me some heck yes. Like, I mean, right on there, a close up of the tooth. It'll take a second to set it up, but do you want to see it? I say we do it. Honestly, I say we do it. So. Just so you know, this is what I have. This is where we're at right now. Look. You see what's going on? This is where this is at. Okay? We're wiped, completely wiped. So, the only thing about this is, I guess what I got to do is I'll get this thing here. Right? Let's get this. So we're nibbling into this wood here. See this? See that there? We're nibbling into that. We got all that. We got all that. We got that. We're good for this year. But I got to go get some more wood this year. Do you guys remember Boston's? I went up to Boston's and cut Boston's trees down. So I'll leave that alone. Go to my Instagram, friends, and watch that little jam that my mother and I did. I want to repeat that because I want you folks who are new to see another piece of me. Friends, I'm learning. Just know that it's my choice to be here and share things with you. I don't feel obligated. I do it because I want to. I want to make you happy. Most YouTubers are people of service. They have something to offer. Other ones, I don't know what they're doing, but I know what I want to do. So,
whoa, what was that? What happened there?
Okay, so I think this is what I'm going to do here, because if I don't, it'll move and rattle on the truck. Do you guys understand what I'm talking about? So let's do it like this. Now, I could... Let's see. Let me get you guys set up. I want to do this so you guys see the top. So how I can do that, I can bring this right in here like this. And what I could do, let's see. So if I go like this, yeah, see, I could get you guys right here. So let me put the file there. So that's where that is. So let's see if we go like this. I want you guys to see very closely what I do. This is oh my goodness, friends, look at the super chats. Friends, we got super chat and supporters here like crazy. You people, I don't even like talking about money, but when people support the channel like this, it's crazy. Hello, Glory and Hammer. These are the reasons we can do these events. They help out big time. I'm so grateful for you people. Thank you. Again, thank you. Now, is this going to be better like this, friends? Will this help this situation if I go like this? Give me hex, yeah. I need to know right away. Is this going to work? Do you guys want that or do you want me back a bit? Let me know right away so I can do this. That's a bit blurry, isn't it? Do you guys want to see it from there? Let's go back just a little bit. I think like that. How about that? Okay, let me see where this goes to when I lean back on it. Like this. Here we go. Okay, you ready? Watch what happens. I think this will work.
So we know I'm not terribly sharp, but there is some raggedness going on. I'm right on my line, friends. I do not want to go past this line, because if I even meet the line, I may as well just go past it or don't stay on it. Look at this one. You gotta pick and choose your battles here. Let me see if I can see this. Oh yeah, I can. Oh, this looks good. Yeah, this is good. Okay, I don't know if you'll see that, but it is ragged a little bit. So I literally just wanna scrape through there a touch. I'm almost on the line there. See, this one's ragged. This one's got the corner knocked off it. Okay, I think we've done what I call a maintenance filing, and I still got the line. I'm still above my line. Yeah, we're done there. So now we switch, we go this way. Now remember, that's dragging on the backside of the tooth, right? See? So we're good. This one's right on the line. Like literally on the line. Tom Carlson, did you just do another super chat? Are you serious? Buy a new chain bucket. Oh, Tom, you psycho man, you. Friends, Tom... You know what I say to you, Tom? That. Tom, I love you. I'll go buy a new chain, Tom. This one's down. Gone. But remember something, friends. Tom. Friends, thank Tom, please. This one I'm hitting a little harder. I'm going down on this one. You want to see something else? Watch this. Thank you. Okay, I think I've got it here. This is what it is when you're a firewood guy. Back in the day, oh boy, oh boy. And we'd start breaking them off. Okay.
Flat file, hang on. Okay, so we have two options here. We have soft and we have hard. Here's my suggestion to you. If you go, friends, this is a 32-inch bar. 32-inch bar, okay? But it's full house, okay?
So I like on full house, I like to go on the hard setting. This is just what I do. That's all, just what I do. Okay? Look at here. Look at. Okay? We're not taking any. Why is that? Well, because I was just freshening up the filing. That's why. There was no real meat taken off. So see? And I could have used a different gauge. Look at the softwood. Let's look. See the difference? Okay? So these rakers are fine. So let's do something. Yeah, these are fine. I'm not even gonna bother. I've checked, I know my chains. See what's going on? Okay, get one of these.
This chain has just been touched up. I don't have really any wood to cut, friends. But I'm gonna fire this thing up and I am gonna cut a couple pieces of wood. Just because I want you to see something.
Okay.
So, let's recap, shall we? ...32-inch bar. Look at. ...7/32 file. If you were using a round file, or pardon me, a round tooth chain, or semi-chisel, you would, sometimes it's better to swap to a 1/13/64, but I don't do it. That's a 7/32 file. I use the same size file all the way from the start to the finish. That's her. Okay, look at this. Are you guys feeling me? You guys feeling me? Now, if this here isn't worn out, whoa, should be good. Hey, who's that? What's going on here? Did someone just super freaking chat? I'm screwed up. Let's go over here. I don't really have anything to cut, but I want to show you something. I'll stand something up, or I'll play around, or whatever. I really don't. Oh, what's that over there? Maybe we do. Maybe we do have a little something in the old firewood pile. I gotta burn this. We got something there.